here at the Guy's Shooting Range for the second event of the week, Trap Men. With the London Olympic Games just barely behind us, these fine athletes have been invited here to duel it out one last time for the 2012 ISSF season. I'm Hilary Russell and have the pleasure of having Great Britain's trap shooter Abby Burton here with us today. Welcome, Abby, and thanks for being here with us.
Hi, yeah, nice to be with you too.
So how are the things kind of slowing down now in Great Britain after the London Games?
Yeah, well, it's always nice to finish a season because they all feel fairly long anyway. But yeah, I mean, obviously I'm all for Ed in this final.
Of course.
And it'd be a good finish to his season.
And tell me a little bit about Ling and his shooting lately. Has he been doing pretty well?
Yeah, he's been very consistent. He's been what they call knocking at the door at pretty much most of the World Cup finals and the Olympic Games. Mm-hmm. You know, and he's just missed out, so he's in this one, so yeah, all the best.
And as we were talking before, it seems as if, you know, it seems like a small event because there's only a limited amount of people that are invited to it, but it's a really, really important event as well.
Oh, totally. And with this, you know, caliber of shooters here at this event, all competing head-to-head against one another, it's definitely going to put the best up against the best.
It certainly is. The pressure is going to be on, and we're going to get started on this in just a couple of minutes. First, I just want to introduce our finalists, and we're just waiting for them to line up here, and then we will start in on that. So coming in with 119 targets in sixth place, representing Spain, we have Jesus Serrano. He is a two-time World Cup gold medalist, a one-time World Cup silver medalist, and a two-time World Cup bronze medalist. Then in fifth place, coming with 120 targets, representing Great Britain, we have your teammate Edward Ling. He was the junior world champion in 2002, and he also won the bronze medal during the World Cup in Lonato in 2003. And in fourth place today, with 120 targets representing Croatia, we have Giovanni Crnogorac. He is the Olympic Games gold medalist of 2012, and he also won a gold medal during the World Cup in Beijing in 2011. And in third place, also with 120 targets representing the Russian Federation, we have Alexey Alipov. He won the gold medal during the Olympic Games in Athens in 2004. He also won the bronze in Beijing in 2008. He's a two-time World Championships silver medalist. And in second place, with 121 targets representing Italy, we have Ermino Frasca. He is 29 years old. He was a junior world champion in 2003, and he also is a one-time World Cup final gold medalist. That was in 2007. And in first place, with 123 targets representing Turkey, we have Oguzhan Tuzun. He won the junior world championships in 1999. He also won the gold 2 years ago in Izmir during the World Cup final. And he's a three-time World Cup gold medalist. So what do you think here, Abby, of these finalists?
Well, obviously the current Olympic champion at the moment, you know, he's quite good at single barrels because he obviously came from sixth position out to win the Olympic Games outright. So, you know, he can do it, and I believe that any of them could do it. My bets are on Ed Ling,
right.
So obviously because it's my country, Great Britain. But yeah, it could be anybody's in the single barrel. You just don't know how it's going to go.
And we're going to get going pretty soon with this, you know, 123 being the highest score, 119 being the lowest. The conditions couldn't be more perfect. Like you were saying earlier, during qualifications, it was kind of overcast, and so the lighting wasn't exactly how it is right now.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, this morning, because I shot as well today in the Grand Prix, and I did shoot this morning and found them, you know, they weren't as clear to see as they are now. I mean, the sun's up high, the wind's dropped, and obviously you've got the green background here at Maribor. It's perfect. It's good.
Do you like this shooting range?
Sometimes.
Okay. Yesterday, unfortunately, you did not make it into the final, right?
No, that's right.
Yeah.
That's right. But yeah, no, it's a very beautiful range to shoot. You know, there's one consistent background in order to see the targets from. Mm-hmm. There's not much more that you could hope for, really.
So we're going to get started now with Jesus Serrano. I would have to say, you know, all of the gentlemen that entered into the qualifying round and also the final round at Olympics, they must have a lot of pressure off their shoulders right now. I mean, World Cup final is a huge event, but they probably are just, and that is
the first
drop by our Olympic gold medalist, Chernogorets.
He still shot 24 in the Olympic Games single barrel, though, didn't he, right?
I believe he did.
Okay.
It was actually an amazing final to watch.
Oh.
You know?
Yeah.
Just did a great job.
Yeah. No, it was very, you know, very up and down. Very, you know, obviously I felt sorry for Michael Diamond because that's the shooter's worst nightmare to go in. But, you know, it does knock your confidence a little bit, but everyone knows he's still a great shot. And
he certainly is. He's
definitely
a great shot, a perfect gentleman, and it was really hard because he had set a new Olympic
record, yeah. 125
did.
At 125, and then to not come away with Olympic medal.
I know.
You know, but that's the way this single barrel final goes sometimes.
How hard is it to change over from one shotgun to another?
I'll let you know. No, I think any shooter of any caliber that can do really well can adapt to the guns and know whether it's right for them or not over a due course of time. I always believe it takes a little while to get into the gun that you're shooting, but once you get the feel of it and get into it, I believe, you know, it can be a good thing. And it could excel, obviously, your shooting as well, depending on the differences between the change.
That's right. There we go, Ling nailing his second target. And so you're going to Italy to train?
Well, I'm going out to Italy first with my coach to see this gun and get it all sorted and mm-hmm. changed and get the measurements and it custom made to myself. And then I'll probably do a little bit of training back at home in the UK. And then we may look nearer to the time just before the competition season start again to do a few Grand Prix and go away and do a little bit of training leading up to that.
Fantastic. As we saw there, Chernogorets with another miss, kind of a rough start for him. I'm kind of curious and like to talk to him about this a little bit just to see how, I wonder if just the pressure of the Olympic Games on his shoulders. You know, I think that that's an amazing feat to win a gold medal, but it must be somewhat of a burden as well to carry that on your shoulders.
Yeah, well, I'm sure, you know, your thoughts perhaps come through, especially when he missed his first target.
Right.
You know, he may have thought of the Olympic Games, but I mean, I'm sure he's probably got his head down, focusing on just this round right now.
Right.
In trying to recover, obviously, what he's done wrong in the previous two shots.
On to Serrano.
Nothing.
Shooting like a star. We were just talking earlier about the Spanish team. They really are an incredibly nice bunch of people.
Oh, they are, yeah. And what I think is absolutely great is, you know, they always smile, say hello. And I think they've actually all sort of slowed down in their preparation and their shooting a little bit. I remember following them once in a official training, and they were all shooting together, and it was, you know, the fastest round I think I've ever seen.
Got Alipov now stepping up. Very clear shot there. Alipov is, as we've seen on our sports presentations here, that he just has a laundry list of awards that he's won in the past.
Oh.
Nice work there by Frasca. And back on now to Tuzun. And there's a first miss for Tuzun. Let's take a look. We've got Tuzun still in first place. He's only one target ahead now of Frasca. And we've got tied up for third, Alipov and Ling.
I do like your front camera. It's like seeing the eyes and what they do and how they mount. And some of them really push their head down, don't they? Or some of them, you know, close an eye or they look away and then look up last minute. I think that's the real good thing with watching it on this live TV, because you can't quite see the front cameras, right, you know, when the actual shooters are shooting, because you don't know where they're looking,
exactly,
or anything like that. But so it's nice to see that.
And it's very interesting to see how many different styles are out there, or the different routines that they have before they shoot. You know, like you were saying, you're closing your eye, or, you know, keeping both eyes open, or just, you know, like Alipov here, kind of shouldering the shotgun here. Again, on now to Tuzun. I remember when he won the gold during the World Cup final in Turkey. Boy, the crowds went absolutely crazy.
Oh, I bet.
Yeah. Tuzun still holding on to first. Nothing's really changed here. Frasca in second. Alipov and Ling still tied up with 124 targets.
Of course, Serrano's got the delay, hasn't he, in order to wait for that as well.
Now, have you been in that position with the delay?
I have been, yes. And I actually think it's far better to have the delay prior to the one person.
Mm-hmm.
Whereas before, in the past, if you remember, it used to always be on peg one,
right,
which wouldn't give that nice steady flow and rhythm to the squad. When it's just consistently before a set person, you can sort of get your feel and rhythm and routine of everything flowing in relation to that.
And do you feel when you are the one that has to wait for the delay, do you feel that that plays a part in how you perform?
I think it can do. Obviously, it depends how you're mentally thinking, whether you're imagining that person saying ready as another shooter, or whether, you know, it's just a case of perhaps your coach in training will say ready,
mm-hmm,
if he's making you do things or go back. So, yeah, I don't think it should hinder too much, because, like I say, it's a consistent seconds before you, rather than all it being on peg one.
And that was a miss for Frasca. Back on now to Tuzun.
It's interesting to see the color lenses they all use as well.
Well, I guess this is more of a preference of... Sorry, you're just going to interrupt just a second. We've now a three-way tie for second place with Alipov, Frasca, and Ling. And Tuzun now has a two-target advantage. Just a personal preference of what type of lenses that you want to wear.
Yeah. I suppose it depends as well on the shooting grounds, the backgrounds. I always like to wear my bronze on a background like this, just purely because it's so green,
mm-hmm,
you know, that it highlights the clay. But obviously the sun's not so bright either. Oh, there's another one for...
Chernogorets. You could kind of hear the audience here, you know, sucking in their collective breath. Alipov is shooting a perfect final up till now. And back on to Frasca, who's just coming off of a miss. And he's gotten right back into the game. Oftentimes with glasses, you can see that the shooters will change them during the final if the lighting's changing a lot.
Oh yeah,
you know?
Totally. I mean,
all right, Tuzun, he had a two-target advantage, so he's eating away at that a little bit. He's now one target ahead. Alipov, Frasca, and Ling still tied up for second place. Also, Serrano shooting a perfect final. And back on to your mate.
That's it. Nice. You know, I think it's all about, I mean, obviously, your adrenaline's going, your heart's going. And I think a lot of people come up and ask me and say, oh, how do you manage the nerves? And obviously, when I went to watch the Olympics as well, you see these people, and everyone has nerves.
Of course.
It's just how you deal with it in that round, and use it for your advantage.
Oh.
So I'm assuming there's really no shaky hand shooters in the shooting world then.
Well, actually, I watched the Olympic skeet men's final, mm-hmm. And there was a guy in that that apparently I found out afterwards used to drive a lot of racing cars, so that's why he got the shakes.
No kidding.
And I was like, oh my God. I know I'm nervous sometimes, but he was really shaking, you know. But I mean, he went on to win a medal, and it was
perfect.
So it just shows. It doesn't matter. Oh, another no bird.
Serrano just looking down. It looks like he just doesn't want to look out into the field of play at the moment. Just wants to keep himself mentally composed.
But he knows it's going straight. Always helps.
They are fast shooters, the Spanish team. You know, they're just amazingly quick. They call and pull at the same time. Again, on to Chernogorets. Nice.
No bird again.
And we were seeing this happen yesterday during the trap woman event.
Yeah.
But there seemed to be quite a few no birds during the final. Another great shot by Alipov, and now moving on to Fresca.
Oh.
Fresca's just doing a really great job. He didn't make it into the Olympic Games, but you can tell that he certainly has been doing a lot of training to get where he is today, right now, here with us.
Oh. And the Italian team always have a good show, regardless of who it is, don't they?
They certainly do. And then I'll tell you, when they win a medal, look out.
Oh, I know. Yeah.
Tuzun still in first by a target, and a three-way tie for second place.
I mean, they got five trap shooters here, haven't they?
They do, yeah.
Two trap women and three trap men. Amazing.
And that is Ling's first miss. Another no bird for Chernogorets.
It almost seems like it's either to do with the microphone or something, because there's no actual visible pieces coming out as a no bird. Hopefully it'll come out this time.
There we go. Back in the game here. Now, we have seen that in the past also with, there's a no bird for Alipov again. With our travels and following the shotgun, that if the call is not made loud enough and the microphone doesn't pick it up, it can really wreak havoc on the shooter.
Oh, yeah. I mean, a lot of the referees, you can just go up to the box and obviously turn the sensitivity up or down. But if the sensitivity is right up, and then obviously you have to either change your call or high in it or something, or louden it in order to get that target to come out, it can, because obviously you're having to use more air or change something. So yeah, you could think about that.
So something for, you know, spectators or people that are watching this that are not shooters, that is probably a hard thing to change. I mean, it sounds like something so small just to speak up a little bit louder, but if you have your own routine.
Yeah, a lot of them would go to the last resort of changing their call in a round, especially a final like this. I think they'd either move across the mat a little bit so that they're directly above the mic, or they would move the mic across.
And that was the second miss for Fresca. These are going to change things around a little bit on the scoreboard. We're so early into this final that you know, anything can happen. We can see things that changed, especially in the last five targets.
Oh, yeah.
And there is a miss also by Tuzun. This is going to, yeah, really change things around. Alipov and Tuzun are now tied up for first place, and we have a three-way tie for third between Frasca Ling and Serrano. Okay, Ling is coming off of a miss, and he just had a no bird. It could be at that first.
It could be just. It just
first
seems
microphone.
To be station one, doesn't
yeah.
it?
Yeah. Ling did not let that one miss that he had affect his shooting by any means. He's right back into the game and back on now to Chernogorets. Alipov still shooting a perfect final. He and Serrano, I believe, are the only two that are shooting a perfect final at the moment. Frasca coming off of a miss. With another miss.
He wasn't happy about that one.
No.
Just seemed to hang on to it a little bit. I don't know, you know, whether it was slightly a delay or...
And you were talking a little bit about that beforehand, that there was a little bit, it seemed like the other day when you were shooting, you said it seemed like there was a little bit of a delay.
Yeah. I don't know whether it's, because I know that they used to, did they used to have Mattarelli traps in here on some of the layouts?
Could have.
But now they're all Promatic. And I think it also depends on which trap you're using with how they appear when they first exit the hole.
Mm-hmm.
And it definitely felt to me, you know, with regards to cooling and the clay coming out, they're not slow by any means, but there just seemed to be that little bit of a difference in a few seconds. Oh, there goes another one.
There goes another one for Chernogorets.
And I think that's why you see sometimes majority of people in finals or not, whether they've got where their gun hole points are.
Mm-hmm.
I think if you look a little bit higher and your gun hole position is higher, you tend to not see the flash or the delay so much because you're waiting for a clay to appear to obviously shoot it, which you should be doing that regardless anyway, but it just helps in different ways.
Okay, Frasca coming off of two consecutive misses. Let's see if he can get right back in here, and he has.
You see some shooters take the full 10 seconds, and some are obviously quicker as well. So again, they've all got different preparation times with regards to quicker, slower.
Nothing's really changed on the scoreboard other than Frasca is in fifth place. He moved down into fifth place after missing the target before this one. Again, back onto Ling. Until he's not happy with that by the expression on his face there. Back on again to Chernogorets, and he has cleared that target.
I think it's worse watching than actually shooting. I can definitely say that.
Frasca definitely back into the game. And again on to Tuzun. It's amazing to see his posture. He has really wraps himself around it.
Yeah. I mean, some of them, they're all, it's all different. I suppose it depends how your body's structured and built to how you feel most comfortable on your gun.
So we have a two-way tie for first, and now only one person is holding on to third place. Again, on to Serrano, having a perfect final, not missing a beat. Ling's got it going on again.
See if it comes out on one this time.
No.
I think he seems to be getting the majority of it, like you were saying earlier.
Yeah, it does, it does seem to do that. Just that I don't know what it is. One shooter seems to get riddled by it, and it's, you know, it couldn't happen to a better guy. But Alipov, I think, is pretty much enough of a veteran shooter that he's he can handle this.
Yeah. You go up and tell him to call louder.
Once again, another no bird.
And pair is getting twitchy over there.
There we go.
I think because what's that doing is, because he's before Frasca, it's all about preparation of your timing. And obviously Frasca just wants to get on with it.
Of course he does. Now for you, what angle is the most difficult target to shoot at?
For me, I mean, obviously there's no one particular target that gets in my way, but if it's anything, I would say more the straight target, just purely because you see it and therefore you react on it sometimes a little bit too quick, because any angle target, you tend to see a little bit of the angle and the gap as it's left the trench, whereas a straight one, you don't get to see, you know, how far you've sort of let it out before, you know, reading the line, basically. And you just tend to move, you know, move on it that little bit earlier, because you think, oh, it's going straight, and then you think, oh, God, it's up there.
Way up there.
Oh, there's another one. And sometimes if you just, instead of watching and you just sit here and listen to the shooter's timing, a lot of the time you can tell whether they've either hit or miss it just through the timing between their call and actually when they've shot.
Well, it's funny you should say that, because Alipov, he called it and then he shot and I thought, he's not going to get that one. It seemed like he shot really kind of slowly.
Yeah.
But obviously he crushed it, so...
It's all how you pick them up. It's how you see them, and obviously not panicking on the flash as it exits. It's all about preparing yourself for, because you know they're going to be fast out. You just got to cover yourself a little bit and take it in your stride.
Now you were saying that you're 25 years old. When was it that you started shooting?
I started shooting. My first competition was actually in 2003 in the Czech Republic. So that was my first junior competition for the European Championships, which I made the finals. I was absolutely over the moon.
Oh, I bet you were.
And back then, when I was that age, I was going in fifth, and all I was concerned about was I didn't want to come out last. You know, so I was like, I'm going in fifth. If I come out fifth or better, then that's great.
That's a great way of thinking about it, actually.
Yeah. But now, it's like, no.
No.
I'm now going for the front.
Okay, let's just focus in now on Tuzun.
He definitely uses the full 10 seconds, definitely, to prepare himself.
Alipov and Tuzun tied up with 135 targets. Serrano is with 134 targets. He is the major scoreboard climber of the day. You know, he came in on a shoot-off to get into the final and has just had an absolutely perfect final so far. Chernogoratz, who seems like he's experiencing a little bit of difficulty, has just missed another target. Alipov making it look very simple, you know?
Oh, it's when you're watching the best, they all make it look easy.
Well, it's true. When they all get into a rhythm, then you can, it's almost like a heartbeat, you know?
Yeah.
One
yeah.
after the other after the other. And, you know.
And what you'll find sometimes is in a squad, and it's very hard not to know, obviously, when people have missed and when people don't. But sometimes I've seen numerous times squads going through where they're all shooting great, and then once one starts missing, then the other, and then the other, and it's like, oh my god.
It's like it's contagious almost.
Yeah. But hopefully not in this case.
Exactly. No.
Keep hitting them. That's what we want.
Chernogratz coming off of a miss with a hit.
That one was a flash. Good hit, though.
It's a very good point. You know, you use flash targets, obviously, for finals, and then you just had, there was just one that was put in there from, obviously, a qualifying round.
Do you know what flash clays they're using at all here today?
No, I don't.
No. You can tell there's no wind because the pink just lingers there.
Alipov and Tuzun still tied up with 137 targets. Serrano in third with 136, and Ling and Frasca tied up with 135.
You're shooting very well.
Again, back onto Ling.
You got it out of the peg one that time.
Unbelievable, huh? Again on to Frasca. He had a little bit of trouble towards the beginning, but he seems like he's really gotten into his own groove and shooting a really good final now. Back on again to Tuzun.
I wonder if there's something in it about, you know, wearing hats.
In what sense?
Well, I don't know, just whether, because I mean the sun's not straight in front of you, but you see a lot of shooters always regularly wear hats while shooting track. Whether it's a concentration thing, like side blinkers,
right.
I don't know.
It could very easily be.
Just a thought that run through my mind, because there's only two of them in this final not wearing a hat.
And that was Ling and Chernograf. An unfortunate miss there by Ling. No.
I didn't see anything come off that.
No,
I
didn't either.
They're giving it him again.
It looks like they are. Mm. He must have seen something. To be honest with you, I was.
Oh. Oh dear.
I've never heard an audience really react that way before. Well, we've got some live ones here today.
It's the new excitement to trap.
Exactly.
They're going to start cheering.
Came back on Frasca.
Yeah. Oh, dear.
Frasca.
I must admit, I didn't think I saw any dust come off of that, but I didn't see any dust,
but maybe he saw a piece. I don't know.
I don't know. But there, I suppose that's what you got the side refs for.
That's right. Alipov and Tuzun still tied up after he was allowed to take another shot, claiming that he had hit a piece of that target off. And Serrano is still in third place. Here in Slovenia, they do have kind of a rowdy crowd, don't they?
Yeah,
it's generally a very quiet sport or spectator sport, you know?
Except for the Olympics.
The Olympics is crazy.
I think it's wonderful, though.
I do too. And I think that it needs to have more of that.
I think they got it in for Alipov now.
I do too.
he won't mind that. He's just, I want to hit every target.
That's right.
However I do it.
Nice, nice hit there by Frasca. Getting down to the last five targets to find out who's going to be on the highest step of the podium. Getting back onto Tuzun.
There don't seem to be too many flash.
No.
Now, whether they've got down to the normal clays. I just hope the others don't think about all the commotion.
That's true.
You know.
I would have to think that for the finalists during the Olympics, it must have been a completely...
Not shooting really well.
He is. I mean, perfect. A little bit disturbing because during the World Cups and during the other competitions, you don't hear a whole lot of commotion.
No.
And go from, you know, almost complete silence to just complete mayhem.
Oh, totally.
It must have been...
I mean, it's Olympics. I mean, it's definitely something if it is in your home country, mm-hmm. Regardless whether you shoot or you don't, just to go and watch it is something else. I mean, obviously, I went to watch Ling at the Olympic Games in London, and just his presence,
yeah.
You know, just to walk out and they were all cheering, and it was surreal. It was great. And if, you know, you can deal with that pressure, then...
Then you can do it anywhere.
Someone's phone
think.
Ringing in the crowd is nothing.
Tuzun, he has three misses from the beginning, but now has really gotten into the zone. Still tied up now with Alipov with 141 targets each. Serrano still holding it on to third place with 140. Alipov and Serrano both shooting perfect finals. Oh. Again, back onto Ling. There's another miss there by Chernogorets. This is what I was trying to ask you about before, Abby. Do you suppose that because he's won the gold medal, that he has that pressure to perform perfectly, and do you think that could be getting to him?
I think it can happen one of two ways. I mean, I think you can go into a World Cup final knowing that you're the Olympic champion, and what really happens, mm-hmm. happens, you know, so you still can't take away that he's an Olympic gold medalist and that's what he will have for the next 4 years.
That's right.
But yeah, I mean, at the moment, I would say he's probably feeling a little bit annoyed or upset with himself for one reason or another with what's going wrong, because I mean, no shooter likes to miss, but
no.
It's just a nice finish to the season is probably what he would have wanted,
right?
But he's still got the Olympic gold medalist, so amazing. Two to go,
really unbelievable shooting by Serrano. Again, back onto Ling.
And sometimes at this stage, they know what they've got to come, which I'm pretty sure Alipov will know what he has to come, because he's very good at counting,
mm-hmm.
counting them off as he goes.
And the crowds are still kind of heckling
to
at him.
To the right,
yep.
There we go. You see him creeping that way?
I could. Okay, again, back on to Frasca.
Oh. We'll see if we can guess Alipov's last target.
Okay.
See if his gun moves.
Again, Tuzun. Tuzun shooting very, very well. Still tied up for first place. And Serrano still in third. Things are not really changing at all on the scoreboard. And we do have just two targets left to find out. Number one, if we're going to be going into a shoot-off, and number two, who is going to be on the highest step of the podium.
See, what could irritate, whether they spot it or not, I don't know, but if you see the little birds of prey out by the bottom of the bank there,
mm-hmm.
flighting in, and I got that one that time.
It always mystified me of how birds would even want to spend any time near a shooting range, to be honest with you, Abby.
I agree. Right, which way do you think it's going this time? Straight, left. Left. Yes. Sneaky.
Sneaky bugger, isn't he? back on to Frasca.
No, it's good shooting.
Very good shooting, actually, today. Tuzun.
No bird.
Let's see if this will get him a little bit off kilter. I can't imagine that it will. He seems like he is one person who can really just focus in and not something let something like a no bird affect his shooting. And that has not affected him at all. So what do you think, Abby? Are we going to be going into a shoot-off?
I would like to see a shoot-off between Alipov and Tuzun.
Yes.
I think that would get the crowd going.
I think
for
so,
sure.
too, without a doubt.
And I know I think who they'd be in favor for, but...
Serrano shooting an absolutely perfect score, moving up from sixth place to third place, and he'll be going home with the bronze. Ling finishing off, last five targets, perfectly shot.
Yeah, he shot that final very well.
He certainly did.
I mean, he was having a couple of second barrels in a round.
Unfortunate way for Chernograf to finish off the final. Back on now to Alipov. Alipov also shooting a perfect final.
You should stay on this page.
Also for Frasca, now let's just see if that contagious missing that we were talking about earlier is going to rub off on Tuzun. I have a feeling that it is not going to happen.
Yeah.
And in fact, it didn't. We'll be going into a shoot-off, Abby, for the gold medal between Tuzun and Alipov. And it should be exciting stuff because the crowds are already a little bit in mayhem about Alipov protesting that
no bird.
And here he is, our bronze medalist from Spain, Jesus Serrano, just doing a banner job, a perfect final, 25 out of 25. And he's going to be going home with the bronze. Just going to wait a couple of minutes before we get this shoot-off going on. All right, so if you had to choose between one or the other, who do you suppose is going to win this?
I'm going to bet for Turkey.
Are you? Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
I think it could go on for a while, though.
I think it could, too. You know, I should probably apologize to you now before this goes on that you'll probably be sitting here for quite a while.
Yeah, that's okay.
And it looks as if Tuzun is going to be the first one to shoot.
Wow, that was fast.
That was really fast shooting.
I think the contestant about the Russian, I'm not sure, actually. I think it's something to do with the Russian, see what's going on there.
This is true. They do seem like they are having quite a heated debate about, this is just turning out to be a kind of a crazy afternoon here. It looks like they are really backing the fact that Alipov did not hit that target, which they allowed to Alipov hitting that target, and now moving back on to Tuzun.
So what would have happened if Alipov had actually lost that target? What would that have resulted in, a shoot-off between Serrano and the Italian somewhere along the lines, Frasca?
It could have. It could have at one point during the final that could have taken place. Yep.
It's exciting, though.
It is exciting, yeah, to see a little bit of action going down here. Getting back onto Tuzun.
Lovely. He's shooting them fast.
Yeah, he really, he's just letting it go. Again, back onto Alipov. If he wins this shoot-off and he wins the gold medal, I'm a little bit nervous of what's going to take place, actually, Abby.
I think every single one in this crowd will go up and give him a great big hug and say, well done.
I hope so. This is what sportsmanship is all
about.
Yeah,
that's right.
Two for two, back and on to Tuzun. Just watching your teammate Ling walk down below. He's just
giving
such
a
nice
smile.
Absolutely. He's well-deserved smile.
He's probably thinking, oh my God, what is she saying?
Only the nicest of things.
Yeah. I'm sure he would have rather have been in the shoot-off himself. He certainly didn't do himself any disgrace because he shot very well. So,
well, first to be invited here and then to make it into the final, you know,
oh,
you have to take your
right.
hat off
that's
for
right.
all of them.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, totally. And, you know, he's just had a year of knocking on the door. And, you know, I mean, he went to the Olympic Games. That's something to be very
incredibly proud of.
So
yes,
exactly.
Absolutely.
So, yeah. Something a breakthrough eventually. I think for someone that's knocking on the door all
yep.
the time, it's going to happen at some point. So
just to be
just have
know,
to
consistent
wait for that time.
And keep
that's
on
it.
Going and keep
that's
on
it.
Thinking positively. Again, on to Alipov.
Did you see that?
I did.
Perhaps they thought they'd make it interesting just press pause on the box. But that's what I'm saying. When you know where it's going, it's all about making sure that, you know, you've actually seen the clay before you move. I think then if the clay had come out of a slight delay, I think Alipov may have sniped it or something, you know.
Let's just take a look and watch him.
Oh!
That's a miss by Alipov. You can tell he's extremely unhappy with that. Our gold medalist, Tuzun from Turkey, is on our screen right now. Unbelievable shooting by Oguzhan Tuzun from Turkey, winning the gold medal. And
I'm glad my guess was right.
Absolutely. And there's our silver medalist, Alexey Alipov, missing out on that shoot-off, but going home with a silver medal. Really fine, fine shooting. Abby, I want to thank you so much for coming and joining me today. I know
thank
we had to
much.
Just kind of push you to come here, but it's been a real pleasure. I wish
that's
you
all, right.
all the best of luck in the future with your shooting.
Thank you very much.
So go get them, all
thank
right?
Thank you.
Okay.
Cheers. Bye-bye.
Member of the ISSF Administrative Council. The bronze medal goes to Jesus Serrano, Turkey, with a total score of 144, Spain. So sorry.
The
silver medal goes to Alexey Alipov, Russia, with a total score of 145 plus two targets. And gold medal goes to Tuzun, Oguzhan, Turkey, with a total score of 145 plus three targets. Ladies and gentlemen, the national anthem of Turkey. Ladies and gentlemen, we congratulate the winners of the Trapman finals. Jesus Serrao, Alexey Alipov, and Oguzhan Tuzun. Thank you so much.